What I noticed at the beginning when I first met Taylor and started hearing about where she was in her life, what was going on. And then I think, you know, my process is to come with a lot of openness and curiosity. You start filming, you get to know someone. I think it just takes time. Yeah, building trust. I filmed alone with her a bunch. No one had filmed her in the studio before, I was telling you earlier. And so that was a big deal. And then I think this, her decision to speak out politically became a really major thing for her, because it was, she's the same person she was when she was 12 years old in a lot of ways, which is something I love seeing when I watch all of her home movies and stuff. She really hasn't changed in this incredible way, despite her stratospheric level of celebrity. But this was a big change, this decision to speak out politically. And I saw it as this coming of age moment and a coming of age story that I thought a lot of people could connect to. You know, this moment where you might have to say to the people who love you most, I hear you, I love you, but I'm going to have to do things differently now. I have to do things in my own way. I have to do this because it's what I believe. And so basically to say that once we filmed that, I just thought this is the climax of the film and everything else should be about building to that.
I mean, the thing with how you came to the film and also what your relationship was with Taylor Swift as a fan or as somebody who just was following her career before you came on board.
Yeah. Well, I knew work really well. I was a fan of her music. I loved her music. I had never been to a show. I didn't really know much about her personal life. I didn't, you know, follow celebrity news really, but I did love her music. I admired her as an artist who had this singular vision for her career. I've been writing songs since she was 15 years old. So I knew all of that. When I got a call, basically, from Netflix, would you be interested in making a documentary about Taylor Swift? And I just immediately thought, yes, you know, of course. But then also, I just felt like I could understand her. And I knew that we were coming from very different worlds in a lot of ways, but I'm also a female artist in a male-dominated industry, and I had suspected there might be some experiences that we shared that we had in common. I was extremely curious about what her life was like, how she ran her art, her business, and also just how she dealt with this extraordinary pressure of a girl who became a woman in the public eye, the level of scrutiny and responsibility that entails. And so from the beginning, I was really interested in how could this be a film not only for Taylor Swift's fans, but also for a film for people who don't realize they're her fans yet, or who might not know much about her, or maybe they don't even like her music, whatever, that they could still watch the film and see, okay, this is not only about the music, this is also about a young woman growing up, going through some stuff that a lot of people go through, and it's the story of a good who feels muzzled in a way, making this decision to take that muzzle off.
So